Well, that was our senior reporter Avu Mdila out in Pretoria. Now from Pretoria to Cape Town, officials say rains are easing and flooding is subsiding along the Garden Route. It caused severe flooding in some towns, forcing closure of schools, roads as well as medical facilities. Some residents have been stuck at home. Relief aid is now being distributed to those affected. Our reporter Ronald Masinda is in the area and joins us live with the latest. Ronald, what exactly is the latest now? We understand aid is on the way. What is the latest?
Good afternoon. Well, today is all about relief aid, and it has been since we started broadcasting earlier this morning. Where you find us at the moment, we are in Wilderness. It's an area where a number of people who are left displaced are being given some form of aid. A number of them are in line and are waiting for food parcels. We're also seeing quite a lot of families who have been offered some accommodation, at least 16 families, and this will take place across the Garden Route in some of the hardest hit areas. We do know that the SAPS here in the Garden Route is also offering some form of assistance. Let's find out a bit more. What do they have to offer? We are joined by Belinda Parther. She is a member of the SAPS. Ma'am, thank you so much for your time. What and how are you offering assistance to displaced residents?
Thank you. Good afternoon. Thank you for the opportunity. Well, basically, we have been requested through our provincial office in the Western Cape, who is coordinating these efforts on request of the Gift of the Givers to provide logistical support to them during the few days that they will be assisting us here in the Greater George area. Basically, what we are doing at the moment is we're providing them our facility at the Eden Cluster, where we are receiving their interlink trucks, and from there on the logistical support will be provided where the aid will be dispatched from. And in addition to that, we are providing operational support from the different station areas where these trucks will be escorted to the communities where the aid is needed.
How long do you expect this to take?
My understanding is, after we had a session this morning with Gift of the Givers as well as the disaster management, is that it will be taking place over a period of 4 to 5 days, depending on where the need is and how they can get the need to those affected areas.
We do know that during the floods, a stern warning was issued to motorists to try and avoid being on the roads. What can you tell us during this time as to did people heed that call?
Oh, that is correct. Yesterday, through the disaster management, they have provided stern warnings together with the traffic for most motorists to please stay off the roads. You can see today we've got a beautiful day in comparison to yesterday, where most of the roads were like rivers. And I must say that the motorists did give their cooperation in support of us in order to let them do what it is necessary for them to do.
All right. Lastly, 33 years in the police force, you were telling me. Is this unprecedented to you?
I must be really honest with you. For me, it's the first time in 33 years.
All right. Thank you very much indeed for your time. Now, as we stand here, we also know that in a number of areas in the George region, we also know that water trucks have been deployed to a number of areas because there's also been issues of water supply and electrical supply. We are expecting the municipality in George to try and go out and try and sort these issues that have plagued the region for about a couple of days. But what we can see in the background, a number of people are just waiting to get some food. We do know that in the area that they live in here in Wilderness, a number of their structures are completely destroyed, but we will be monitoring the situation, just checking as to how things unfold. But we spoke to several residents in other areas in Tembalethu. We spoke to a resident there saying that, you know, they wish that a lot of aid can come sooner to them because they are really under a lot of distress. And also in suburban areas, where a number of people say that they wish that at least the insurance companies can offer them some form of relief as they've lost quite a lot during the storm.
No, hopefully the aid will come soon enough, but a bit of relief that the weather is looking much better today. That was our reporter Ronald Masinda out in George. More news and updates.